At 11, trouble on the MBTA. A door panel falls off a Green Line train in the middle of a ride. Tonight, the T says it knows what went wrong and it's taking action against one of its inspectors. Jim Armstrong joins us live in Boston with this story. Jim?
Elisa, as a matter of fact, late today we learned that a Green Line inspector will in fact face disciplinary action for not making sure that the doors on this trolley were closed as it pulled into the Park Street station during the very busy morning commute.
I heard people screaming and I turned around and the door had just been torn off of the train.
Rebecca Strong has plenty of crazy stories from taking the Green Line every day, but this one is for the books.
From the moment I got on at Copley, the door was not shutting properly. It just wouldn't close, so they had like a worker like manually holding it closed.
Around 8:30 Tuesday morning, her Green Line trolley was already in rough shape, limping along and about to be shut down for maintenance.
It's all of a sudden when the middle doors that were supposedly disabled came flying open. We're in between Boylston and Park Street at this point.
Other riders turned around in surprise to see fellow passengers jumping back from the now open middle doors.
And you could just really hear them completely get, with a really loud noise, get ripped off.
A T spokesman tells WBZ the doors came loose and a panel torn off by something inside the tunnel.
And I think that's the biggest concern that ever flashed through my head is after the doors were ripped off, we were still moving.
No one was hurt and everyone left the trolley at Park Street. All of them thankful the car wasn't more crowded at the time.
My hope is that an incident like this is sort of like a wake-up call maybe.
And in that case, that phone's been ringing for quite a while to no avail. That said, however, progress is promised. Today's Green Line trolley was actually close to 30 years old. It's part of a fleet of close to 90 trolleys, all about that age, that's actually set to be rehabbed and refurbished at some point over the next 2 years. Live in Boston, Jim Armstrong, WBZ News.